Drag racing's entertainers were back in town. Nitro Championships attracted in excess of 230 entries in 11 separate categories. A bumper crowd of 25,000 people crammed into Sydney's Eastern Creek for the final drag race meeting of the season. Contesting the sixth round of their national series, the nitro-burning top fuel cars took centre stage. And the long-awaited confrontation between Victoria's Rochelle Splatt and Sydney's Jim Reid had the experts describing the clash as the battle between beauty and the beast. Despite dramas on Saturday, Reid top qualified with a scintillating pass of 5.48 seconds.
Yeah, yesterday we were experimenting. We tried two or three different tune-ups and clutch settings and, well, they didn't work.
Top fuel in Australia really is alive and well.
Yes, so is drag racing. Look at the crowd.
The crowd were now watching Reid, 10 times Australian top fuel champion, and 23-year-old Rochelle Splatt, Australia's queen of speed, side by side in a qualifying run over the quarter mile. Reid got there first and hence transferred to the first round against Melbourne's Keith Agis. For the first time in 8 years, Jim Reid red-lighted, handing an easy victory to the Victorian. This shot shows Reid's red light reaction. He jumped the start by just 0.007 of a second. Sydney's Rod Bradshaw, a hardware store proprietor, prepared for battle against Rochelle Splatt, who after just 5 months racing in top fuel, has been offered the chance to drive in America, a challenge she's going to pursue, but not until the business of beating Rod Bradshaw is out of the way.
Right, yeah, well, the car's going really well. It's taken off from the lights good. All the times we're doing are really good, so we hope to go out there now at this time and do a really good run, hopefully.
Rochelle discovered that top fuel cars can be quite temperamental. At half track, her clutch exploded in spectacular fashion. In a day of upsets, Bradshaw would now transfer to the final to meet Victoria's Keith Agis. But mechanical problems meant that Bradshaw couldn't take his place on the start. Rather than let Agis run a solo pass, Mark Shepherd was asked to replace Bradshaw. You can bet Shepherd wished he hadn't accepted the invitation. Whilst Mark Shepherd was contending with an unexpected onboard barbecue, Keith Agis blasted to a 5.99 second pass to win Top Fuel Eliminator.
Consistent but not super quick times, and that's always been your secret.
Yeah, well, you've got to get the car running right, and then once you've got it right, you can try things with it and see if it'll go a little bit better. Sometimes it goes a little bit slower, but you've got to put on the best show you can for the crowd, so I've got to go down every time I possibly can. If I can go a little bit quicker, I try harder, but we'll just see what happens.
Few drivers in Australian drag racing enjoy the popularity of Victor Bray, a Queensland tomato farmer. He's the leading light in the Superstock category. On his way to the final, Bray shattered the national Superstock speed record and passed the elusive 200 mile per hour barrier. In the final, it was simply a case of going through the motions. A 7.10 second pass, on his way to becoming king of the kids. Pro Stock Bike were also conducting a round of their national title. In the far lane, Les Donnan took on the flamboyant Igor Kronowski in the final. Les Donnan wins in 8.28 seconds. Whilst in Pro Stock Sedan, Tony Wedlock emerged victorious in 8.23 seconds. In other motorsport news, on Saturday night, June 5th, the Sydney Showground will reopen for our once-yearly trip down memory lane. The time-honoured 43rd running of the Australian Speed Car Grand Prix will be supported by solos and sidecars. For those that recall the brutal halcyon days in Australian Speedway, it's a must at the nation's most famous Speedway venue.